video, and I hope you enjoy it because I'm probably going to have a blast making it. I would also like to add that this is my first roleplay video. Why do I use brackets? It's because it's not my first day, it's my first roleplay video. It's actually my second, but the first one really didn't turn out well, and I wasn't fully into it. It was right at the beginning when I was starting my channel, and I just didn't really know how to do stuff, so it really didn't turn out quite well. Although it's a subject that I'm planning on developing, the Broken Hearts series of videos. I'm going to be developing that a little bit more, hopefully with better quality, now that I'm a little bit more used to the videoing side of things. And this video will be a mixture of soft-spoken and whispering, because I think it suits the theme that I've chosen. So if you don't like the mixture of both soft-spoken and whispering in the same video, I would advise that you just not watch the video, because it's not gonna work for you. Obviously, everything isn't for everyone. Not everyone has the same triggers. So if what I'm putting out there doesn't correspond to you, all you have to do is not watch them, or watch them a little bit to find out if what I'm doing is corresponds to you. But if it doesn't, just zap the video. Everything isn't for everyone. I would like to invite you to sit back or lay down and just relax to this a little bit fantastic video. By fantastic, I don't mean it's super good, I don't know how it's going to turn out. I mean it's a sort of fantasy, as you can tell from the outfit. Anyway, I'm blabbering on. I will see you in a second for the rest of this video. Hi, Pixie. It's wonderful to see you. You are looking absolutely gorgeous today. What have you been doing to your mane and your coat? I mean, it's so shiny, and you're just so pretty and luminescent today. You are taking such good care of yourself. I am so proud of you. Oh, my little friend. You know, I really miss the time that we spend together. We have so much fun, you know, and... Did you see that? Look. That's so weird. What do you think it is? Let's go and have a look. I'm very curious. It's opening its eyes. Look. Wow. You look so disoriented, my friend. You look so lost. And you're not like us. What are you? I've never seen anything like you before. What are you? What am I? What are we? Well, we're unicorns, duh. Can't you tell? You know, we have the... We're unicorns. I thought that was pretty obvious. But you are absolutely, completely different. Where do you come from? Earth. That reminds me of something we learnt in class a while ago. You know, that the mythological creatures session we did in school with the dragons and the homers. You know, from what we read in school, this creature seems very much alike, very similar to the humans that we learnt about. But humans are mythological creatures, they don't exist. But obviously Unitopia has its facts wrong because you're here. Wow. We just discovered a mythological creature. Wow. Well, that begs the question to how you got here. You don't know? You don't remember anything? Well, looks like you've got quite a long journey ahead of you to figure out how to get home. I mean, that's if you want to go home, because from what we read in our books and in our lessons at school is that Earth, is it that you called it? Really isn't that great a place to be right now. Apparently, the human, I think I'm pronouncing that correctly now, the human race apparently is just so mean and selfish and harmful to one another. Not taking care of their planet, and that there are lots of bad intentioned people down there, and that is such a big change from Unitopia, because Unitopia is very peaceful. And the people are very open-minded and very, very caring towards one another. You won't find in Unitopia a single person that isn't, a single unicorn that isn't well-intentioned and that doesn't want your best interests. Don't put your best interests at heart before anything else. So, I can tell that you're very tired and stressed out from waking up in this strange place for you. And, actually we can help with that, because us unicorns, we have, for starters, unicorns in themselves. We have, obviously, horns that, among other things, allow us to center and canalize our emotions better than humans can. So the horn kind of absorbs all the negative energies that can be around you, all the negative thoughts, everything that can make you feel bad, it absorbs it. And every once in a while we have to cleanse them to get rid of the negative energies, and so they can bring absorb more positive energy and not get completely saturated. So we do that once in a while. So yeah, us unicorns have that special gift of being able to, for ourselves, help us de-stress, and we have this particular talent for actually being very calming in nature, very pure and very sensitive and just basically helpful. And you obviously seem very stressed out from your journey and waking up in a place that you don't know. So me and, oh, where are my manners? This is Pixie, by the way. Pixie is my best friend. I love her to pieces. She's just a wonderful little unicorn. She's got such a lovely, bubbly personality. But she has a handicap and she can't stand on her own. But whatever you do, do not mention it to her, because she is very, very sensitive on that subject. So I would advise, do not mention it. So I'm going to put Pixie down right now. So I'm going to try and help you relax. First of all, I'm going to be using what us unicorns use when our horns aren't performing at their maximum capability, when they're a little bit saturated. Sometimes we need a little bit extra help. So we have these little companions, who are very sweet little creatures, and I must say that they smell really good, and they just help us relieve some of that excess stress that our horn was not able to absorb. So here they are. They're called Squeezmees. And they're just so cute, and even smelling things that smell good can be really satisfying and stress relieving. So they smell so good. Here, have a smell. Yeah, I know, they smell like cream. They smell like I could eat them. But they're not edible, because we unicorns eat grass, and these are not made out of grass. So I'm going to try and relieve a little bit of your stress by making some slow hand movements with these, and making a few satisfying noises with them. And see how they, when I press on them, they take a few seconds to resume their former form, and that particular characteristic that they have is very stress relieving. So I'm going to do this for a couple of minutes just to help you relax a little bit more. beside you so that you can squeeze them at will. You can keep them. I can get more. There's no problem. So, that must have been some journey you had from Earth to Unitopia. Well, I hope that you managed to find your way home. But then again, maybe after a while of trying to figure out how to get home, you might end up enjoying Unitopia more than you would have thought, because Unitopia is really, really a very peaceful place, and well-being prospers. Unicorns, we never get depressed, and we're always happy and bubbly because our world is just perfect, and we all absolutely love living here. There's so much freedom, there's no judgment, people are just so accepting. I heard that on Earth, a lot of people are mean and hurt each other, and I just can't imagine a world where you can't leave your door unlocked without being afraid of being attacked in your own home. I just can't imagine that, and if that's what you're used to, I can honestly say that I think that you're really going to enjoy spending time in Unitopia. But whatever you choose, the choice is up to you. If after spending a little bit of time in Unitopia you do realize that you want to go home, you may do so once you've found out how, because there's literally no recorded case of this ever happening. Unitopia is a different universe from Earth. So maybe you stumbled across some sort of time-dimensional space warp black hole thingy. I don't know, it's really never happened before, so I don't know what to say. But in any case, whether you decide to just stay here while you're figuring things out, or once you've figured out how to go home, if you decide to go home, whichever, you'll still have to spend a little bit of time here while you're figuring out how to go home. So, in the meantime, if you ever need anything, some help, some guidance, if you just need to talk, have a shoulder to cry on, you'll find just down the road towards that way. A little bit further up the road, you'll come across a small village, and the first cottage that you come across when you enter the village, on the left, that's my cottage. And so anytime if you need anything, don't hesitate to come and knock on my door, and my door will always be welcome. And my door will always be open to you, and you will always be welcome in my home. And I would be happy to help you in any way that I can. And the Pixie feels the same way. Us unicorns, as I said before, are very caring, and we can tell that you are in distress. So we want to help you. stroked and tickled. Oh, Pixie, you're so adorable. She's my best friend and I love her to bits. I'm sure that you're probably going to want to get on with your quest in finding a way home, or maybe settling down in Unitopia, because you might realize that it is almost like paradise. So I hope you find your way. And as I said before, if you need any help, straight down the road, cottage on the left, as you enter the village is mine. I'll be happy to receive you, give you refreshments, and maybe a meal, because you might be hungry, and I'll just welcome you into my home, and help you along your journey. If you need to be guided, we could do some walking together. I could show you around and explain a little bit about the locations in Unitopia, which are full of history, 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 history. And I just want to come back to the fact that I'm just so flabbergasted that I've actually met a human. I'm sorry, in our universe, in Unitopia, in our world, humans are myths. And no one's ever seen a real human before. And the fact that I'm seeing one right in front of my eyes, I just feel so blown away. Really? Wow. Unicorns in your universe are also myths? Wait till the school finds out about that. I'm sure I'm going to make academic achievement with this discovery. Wow, I never thought that this would happen. But seriously, putting aside the excitement of discovering that humans are not myths, as much as you discovering that unicorns are not myths, we just don't live in the same dimension and universe, that also may help the science on parallel universes. Anyway, this is just so much for me to wrap my head around. So I'm just going to wish you well on your journey. And again, if you need anything, don't hesitate. You know where to find me. But before you go, I'm just going to relax you a little bit more with the Squeezmees. Give these to you because you need them way more than I do. Don't worry, no, I insist, take them, please. It would make me so happy if, even just for a moment, they could help you on your journey by relaxing, which will help you focus on finding the right answers that you seek. Here you go. I'll just pop these down by you, near where you're sitting. Okay. So, I was going to say goodbye. Be nice. Let me just consult with Pixie first. Agreed to my proposition. If you're interested, we're not forcing you, but just putting the offer out there in case it might help you, and I think it might help you. We could accompany you at least to the next village and show you around the village and help you maybe even show you around a little bit more of Unitopia, so we can help you get a little bit integrated and learn about our customs and our way of life and just about unicorns in general, because I'm guessing if in your world we're myths, you don't have much information on us, just like in our world you're myths, so we don't have much information at all on human beings. So if you'd like, we could accompany you for a bit on your journey, if that would help. Yes, do you think that would help? Okay, great. We'll do that. Hey, Pixie? We're going to be able to help this nice man. Isn't that nice? I love helping people, don't you? Yes, it's so amazing. I'm so sorry. We get caught up in our little conversations. You know what best friends are like. You do have best friends on Earth, don't you? Oh, good. At least that's one good thing that Earth has going for it. Or at least mankind. Okay. So, if you'll follow us, we will escort you to the next village, the village where we live. And from then on, we can figure out where we want to go. We can explain stuff first, and then you can decide what you want to do and how you want to go about it. And so, let's go. Let's go walking. After you. Okay, ladies first. You're such a gentleman. You're such a gentleman. Okay, ladies first. No problem. Thank you. Much appreciated. Well, what are you waiting for? Aren't you coming? Come on. Hello again. I hope you enjoyed the video. I certainly had fun making it. I love getting dressed up in so any videos that involve dressing up and whatever, I really like doing. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. It's a shame that they don't have the option to put more than one thumbs up, because maybe I'd get more likes. Anyway, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Even share it if you're feeling daring. Down in the description of the video, you will find the link to the channel that I named at the beginning of the video. You will also find the link to my Facebook account if you would like to follow me on Facebook, because I tend to post pictures before, during, and after my filming. Also post my thoughts, written posts of my thoughts and feelings about being an ASMRist YouTuber, and I also post my bloopers on Facebook sometimes. For example, from this video, there was a really funny blooper that I just had to keep. And so I put it on my Facebook account, so if you're interested in seeing that blooper that really I thought was hilarious, go and check out my Facebook account, and I accept all friend invites, because it's not a personal account, it's only for my channel, and so there's no personal information on it, and that's why I accept anyone and everyone who wants to add me on their Facebook friends list. And in the description you will also find my Instagram account. I still haven't figured out how to use the links, how to get a link from Instagram, but basically you just copy and paste the name that will be down in this description. It's @MissBlueASMR. numerous technical difficulties in the making of my videos and in the publishing and the editing. So for the moment I'm doing my best, but I'm struggling a little bit with on certain points. So I'm hoping that in the future it's going to come more natural to me and it's going to be easier. I will try and post my next video as fast as I can, because I really like this rhythm of going, you know, straight from one video to the next. I just love it, but technology doesn't always allow that, so. But I am doing my best to, I want you to know that I'm doing my best. I'm actually ill right now, but I had a moment where I was spontaneously feeling better, so I thought best make the most of it while it lasts, do the video, that way it's done, because I've been itching to do it for days, and so I took advantage of the fact that I was feeling better for a little bit, and so here it is. I will see you. I realise sometimes I ramble on a little bit. I'm very sorry about that, but it's just the excitement, because I really love having this channel and growing it and watching it grow, and the community, the ASMR community, is so warm and welcoming, and I just love it. I would like to say a big thank you to all the ASMRists, fellow ASMRs that are taking the time to watch my videos and to like and subscribe and just to comment and show their support. It really touches me and it really helps me in my journey. So I'm also trying to do the same thing for other ASMRs by installing the support system. So talking about that, if you want to be added to my list, obviously I haven't got eyes everywhere, I can't see everyone's channel, I try my best, but I just can't do everyone. So if you want to be added to the support system list, just comment one of my videos, or send me an MP on Facebook, on my Facebook account, which is, the link is down in the description, and I'll just add you, and you'll get a naming in my videos. It's as simple as that, and it's just my way of showing my appreciation and my support towards other ASMRs, YouTubers like myself. So anyway, this video is over. I would like to say a massive thank you for watching until the end, and I wish you pleasant